You still sound fantastic for an old timer, huh? And hey, once again, greetings and salutations. Yours true to the Gator with the heater. The big boss with the big cock sauce. And as I glance at the big tick tock on the fantastic WIBG Tower Power Clock, you and I do know if you are listening to Mr. Hyatt, if you are listening to the Rocking Bird, that this will be the fading weeks of one of the most fantastic, all fantastic stations throughout the entire nation. So if you're game, take that musical ride with yours truly, the Gator with the heater. Through the past, and you come on down to 1621 Chester Street at a place called Memories West, and we will properly entertain you. So if you prepare right now, here we go! For these fantastic velvets, if you're driving right now, remember, take some care, take some safety with you. Tonight. No question about it, no denying yours true to the Gator with the heater. Big boss with the hot sauce. If you are driving along right now, let me remind you that we are going to be with you for the next solid 6 hours, huh? And I mean this high. It's been quite a long time since the Gator heard your voice, but you did your thing. This is Little Richard.
Making the rhythm and blues.
Making merry on WIBG with yours true to the Gator with the heater. The man by the name of Big Bad Chuck Berry. And as I said, if you are listening for the first time, you are going to miss the most fantastic thing. So I don't want you ever to change that dial. The entire population knows that WIBG, this will be the last week. Starting next week, there will be a brand new radio station. But the excitement that has been created throughout the entire years with all of the people associated with WIBG shall be recaptured and created with a new and better radio station. If you are driving along right now listening to the Gator, I want you to know that we are broadcasting live, and we will be broadcasting live for the next solid 6 days from 6 o'clock up until 12 midnight. We will have people like Lloyd Price who will be coming by later on this evening. We expect a phone call from Dick Clark from the West Coast. Chubby Checker, the Dobells will be coming by, the Ronettes. These are some of the great stars that owe their success to the radio station called WIBG. So if you're listening to me, and if you're just coming home from the Seashore Resort areas for Julie and the gang, all the gang, Joe, Ricky, for Willie, you come on by. We're located at 1621 Chester Street. Very shortly, we will take our microphones outside and talk to some of the people who are right here on Chester Street. And very shortly, we will take our microphones inside to the people who are hanging right out here at Memories. The year was 1957. And gentlemen, was a fantastic, great talent of yesterday. Mr. Bobby Darin with a song.
Every night I hope and pray. You walk. Yes, you walk. You walk. That's the walk.
You better walk on down here now. Come on now, y'all.
You don't know what it's all about. Come to me, I'll show you how. We'll do it fast. We'll do it slow.
Salsa Center of the Cotton, Mr. Jimmy McCracklin on WIBG to give it up. If you are, as I said, just driving along from the Seashore Resort areas, and if you are doing nothing, I must remind you that we will be broadcasting live from Memories West, located at 1621 Chestnut Street. So come on down, and very shortly we will give you a number where you can reach us and ask us for any particular dedications. You know, when you talk about some of the great artists that WIBG made, you have to talk about a little guy from North Jersey by the name of Frankie Valli. And incidentally, Mr. Lynn, if you're listening to me, kind sir, you do stand to be corrected. For if I recall, sir, you said that Berry Gordy went to the bank and for $500, and you wanted to know how he got that. Well, the days were a little different than they are today. In those days in Detroit, you can go into the bank and get $500. But you then played, you then did say that the first big song was by Mary Wells. It was not. The first song to put Mr. Berry Gordy on the map was a song that Dick Clark played called Shop Around by the Miracles. Then came Mary Wells, you see. And then came a man by the name of Bob Gaudio. And before Bob Gaudio came a man by the name of Phil Spector. And before Phil Spector came a man by the name of Doug Arthur. And before Doug Arthur came a man by the name of Frankie Valli.
Hey.
Happy Valley. If you are driving along right now, remember, if you are doing nothing, come on down and hey, right now. These songs are throughout the entire years that have captivated the eyes and the ears of the Gita with the Gita, huh? The gentleman by the name of Mr. Marvin Gaye at one time used to sing with this particular group, you know. The name of the group, The Rainbows, the name of the song. My name is the Gita with the Heater. You're listening to WIBG. If you are driving, come on by. We are going to be here at 12 o'clock tonight, and later on we'll dance. And if you were here with the Gita at Memories West at 1621 Chestnut Street, you would be amazed to see two very pretty ladies up front doing a little bit of the old jitterbug. We will have an opportunity to talk to them. Remember, this is WIBG.
I bet most younger sisters feel the way I do. People compare me to my sister, Chris Evert, but I'm me, Jeannie Evert. Sure, I love tennis, but I love the ocean. I have a husky named Phoenix, and my face breaks out. But not as much as it used to. Now I'm using Listerix scrub, and it really helps. Listerix is a lotion with tiny scrubbing beads. It opens the pores and helps keep my skin clear.
Listerix scrub for pimples. Use as directed. Golden or fresh herbal.
Listerix helps me, Jeannie Evert, to be my best.
Yeah, Jeannie looks pretty good. As a matter of fact, this is a lady. A young lady, what is your name?
Kathy Smith.
Kathy Smith, is that the daughter of John Smith?
Right.
How do you like Jitterbug in the night?
I love it. My sister taught me everything I know.
Is that from listening to WIBG and Bob Marlowe?
It sure is.
Yeah, okay, well, we're going to invite, tell all the people to come down here. Go ahead.
I sure will.
Okay, come on down. You're listening to The Gita with the Heater in the background. A gentleman by the name of Curtis Lee. Fiction is back from The Gita's Almanac. This was one of the early songs produced by Mr. Phil Spector. Do right now, because we've got some beautiful young ladies. Young lady, come here, young lady. What is your name?
Jean,
where are you from, Jeannie?
Lansdowne,
PA. Now, how old are you, Jeannie, now?
25.
25 years old. Now, for the people who are listening to The Gita on radio, as I said, these are just some of the fine people who are here. If you are driving along, coming from the seashore, come on by to Memories West, and we will put you on the radio, just like Jeannie. Jeannie, when was the first time you can remember listening to WIBG, love?
when I was about 8 years old.
8 years old? Now, being half Italian, half Jewish, I would say my arithmetic is good, but it's not that good. You know how many years ago that is?
17.
You must be a mathematician, right? 17 years ago. Are you waiting for the new change with WIBG?
Yes.
You know, it's crazy because I just came in from the shore, and you never really, really know. I think the greatest thing about a disc jockey or a radio station is the acceptance that through the years people will give either a disc jockey or a radio station, and through the years IBG has been number one. And when you really get into it, especially from my experiences this last weekend at Memories down in Margate, it's amazing how many listeners out there IBG really still has, and it's amazing how much curiosity this whole thing has created. What would you like to hear from WIBG now that they are changing their call letters? Do you have any idea what you would like to hear in the way of music or format, as they say?
Well, I'd like them to stay the same, really, as they were.
Well, I'll tell you, from what I understand, and we'll have to find out from the general manager who will be here later on, we'll try and get a little more of an insight. Let me take my microphone right over here. Here's a gentleman sitting with a pretty young lady. Hi, sir, what is your name?
Yeah, Dave.
Dave, how are you, Dave?
Not bad. How are you?
Well, I'm trying to make up for an old time. You see?
Okay.
Yeah, you know the Gita got a little gray. You got a little gray
my beard here.
Your little gray beard. Listen, who's this pretty young lady next to you?
Oh, this is my honey.
Oh, your honey, Joan. Yeah. Well, ask me a question, Dave.
Oh, baby.
You're a little Wayun, a little bit of a baby, right? Where are you from?
I'm from Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, that's the home of a guy by the name of Porky Chetwick.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Daddy on the radio.
I'm the geeta with the heater, the boss with the hot sauce. Young lady, would you like to say a couple of words to the fine people out there, huh?
No, thanks.
Are you from Pittsburgh, too?
No, I'm from Jersey.
Jersey, what part of Jersey?
Voorhees.
Voorhees Township, that's where the great big mall is, huh? Okay, David, you're from Pittsburgh.
Her dad doesn't know, like, that she's saying.
Oh, that's very good. This will be another first right here at WIBG. Okay, that's good. We'll call you Alice, and we'll call you Tim McCoy, okay?
Slim.
Okay, we're going to swim. I'm going to take you back right now to the year 1956. In 1956, there was a man by the name of Bob Warren. He was the granddaddy of Bandstand. Do a dance in the Carmen roller skating ring to this song entitled